Wasn't enough for you? Murder, to be precise. I'd like to ask you a few questions.
Yes, of course.
First of all, I want to know about your movements today.
Movements? What are you implying?
Look, she was killed outside the prison, run down by a car. Now, I'm not implying anything. I've just got to question everyone who has a motive and opportunity.
Motive? And what possible motive could I have?
Well, if what Terry Harrison tells me is correct, a very good one. I mean, you and he have been a little, friendly, shall I say?
What's that got to do with anything? My private life's my own concern.
Your private life has a direct bearing on my investigation. Now, Harrison also told me that you were upset about having his ex-wife around the place.
How dare you? He would never accuse me of anything like that. You're twisting his words.
Am I?
This is my home and I want you to leave.
So you're not going to answer the questions?
I'll answer anything that's asked properly and without insinuation and with witnesses present.
Oh, come on, you can do better than that. You sound like one of the bloody prisoners. That's what they asked for.
Get out.
With Kathy Hall out of the way, you've got a direct line to Harrison. Now, that's a very good motive. You think about that, and we'll talk later.
I hope you're satisfied.
Vera?
Inspector Grace was just here, but I suppose you know all about that.
Oh, no, wait a minute. Slow down. I mean, he's investigating Kathy's murder. He's got to ask questions. What are you angry at me for?
He practically accused me of murder. That's what for.
What?
Don't act so surprised. Why should you be after what you said to him?
Oh, no, look, I don't know what you're talking about. What did I say to him?
That I'd be relieved to have her out of the way, that it would give me a clear field with you.
But I...
Oh, look, don't bother denying it. Somebody told him about us. Someone who put those ideas in his head.
Look, Vera, I may have mentioned our relationship, but
Oh, don't bother.
I just don't know how I'll manage. With the kids running wild and the business falling apart.
Come on, Don, you're handling it really well. But even the strongest man would crack after what you've been through.
Strong? Not me, Janet. I used to think so, but... since Alison's been away, I've realised how much I depended on her. She was the strong one.
Yeah, you must be really lonely without her. I know what it's like. I'm often lonely myself. I just wish I could help you some more. I could come over more often, I suppose, help with the kids.
What?
I said I'd like to be able to help you some more. I mean, I quite enjoy cooking meals, cleaning up.
You've been very good to us.
Oh, it's nothing. I think lonely people should help each other out.
I suppose so.
Listen, Don... you know, if ever you feel the need to talk, all you have to do is ask. I tell you what, why don't I come over later tonight and cook a decent meal, and then when the kids are asleep, we can have a nice long talk.
Oh, excuse me.
Morris, it's good of you to come so quickly. Please come in.
Is that right?
I'd like to meet a neighbour of mine, Janet. Janet, this is Mrs. Morris, who's trying to help with Alison.
How do you do?
Nice to meet you.
Please sit down. Pour you a cup
Thank
of tea.
You.
Yes. Would you like some scones? Janet's just made some.
Oh, that's nice of you.
Oh, I didn't mind. Alison's brought so much trouble to the family, it's the least I can do.
It's just as hard on Alison as it is on the rest of the family, you know.
Yes, well, I suppose it is. She did bring it on herself, though.
Well, it's very generous of you to take your time out to help.
She's been absolutely marvellous. I don't know what we'd have done without her.
Yes, well, I suppose I should be getting back, really. I've got some things to do, and I'm sure you two would like to talk alone.
Thanks for the afternoon tea.
Anything I can do, you know that.
It's nice to have met you.
Yes. Well, see you later, Don.
Bye. Vera, I've got to talk to you.
Don't waste your breath.
Now, wait a minute, wait a minute. What's going on? You ring me up, you abuse the hell out of me, you won't let me get a word in edgeways, and now you're slamming the door in my face.
What did you expect? To be welcomed with open arms? I'm the one who should ask what's going on.
Vera, nothing is going on. It's all a misunderstanding, that's all. Please, let me in. We'll talk about it.
Thanks to you, I had Inspector Grace here, treating me as though I were a criminal.
Now, look, I don't know what he's told you, but I wouldn't have said anything to make him do that.
He knew about us.
Well, lots of people know about us.
Vera, if I hadn't said anything to him, somebody would. Well, don't you think that's a bit strange? That's all. I just mentioned it.
Exactly what did you say?
Well, look, to tell you the truth, I can't remember. I was upset. They just found Kathy. Vera, I'm sorry if Grace upset you, but he upset the whole prison with his accusations. It wasn't just you.
And it wasn't very pleasant.
Vera, I wouldn't say anything to hurt you. You should know that.
All right, I believe you.
Thanks. Vera, I know you won't consider starting up again, but... well, we can still be friends, can't we? Maybe we could have dinner together. What do you say?
We'll see.
I didn't realize the enormous effect it would have on the family.
Mm, particularly the children, if I know my job. You're going to have to spend a lot more of your time with them now, you know.
Just the point, I haven't got the time. Since Alison's been away, there's no one to answer the phone. I'm losing jobs, creditors are screaming for money, and everything's just collapsing.
Now, hang on, Don. It won't be for much longer. And Alison isn't exactly wasting her time in prison. She's using what skills she has and picking up a few more. Now, when she gets out, she could get a job, and that would help you all financially.
But I need her here.
Don, one of Alison's problems was that she had no sense of her own worth. That and boredom. Now, a job of her own could take care of all that.
It'd also give her gambling money.
No, that's only a symptom of the problem. I think you'd find that that had vanished pretty quickly.
Perhaps you're right. That's no help to me now, is it, Mrs. Morris?
Look, I think I should get in touch with Prisoner's Aid. I'm sure they'd be able to come up with some help.
No way. It was a prisoner organization that bashed Alison, remember?
No, you don't understand. They're not prisoners. They're businessmen, housewives. People like yourself who've joined together to help each other.
Oh, I still don't like the idea. Maybe I could ask Janet if she'd help. She did offer.
Yes, well, I suppose she could. But I think you need organized help. Now, you think about it.
Well, you sound as though you had a terrific time.
Of course. Sid treats me like a real lady.
Well, I'm looking a whole insanity against him.
He's looking better, too. He reckons because I'm looking after him.
Oh, God, give me strength. Well, I'm glad thinking about him's cheered you up. You're a mess when you got back here.
Yeah, that bloody Grace.
Not the nicest person in the world.
Mm. Who do you reckon did it?
Well, I know what I think, but I've got no proof.
Yes, Mr. Harrison was awfully anxious to get her out of here.
You're right. Even when she bashed up Paige, he didn't even give her any more time.
Well, I'll tell you something else, too. She did everything in her power to stay in here. He wouldn't even put her on report. She got away with bloody murder.
And maybe he did, too.
Why would he do that?
Who knows? All I'm sure of is I don't want to be left alone with him until whoever did it is caught.
Oh, it'd have to be nuts to try anything else.
It'd be nuts to try anything in the first place. I don't like the idea of being locked up with a killer screw.
Thanks, Vera.
What for?
For having dinner with me tonight. And the meal, being with you. It's made me feel almost human again.
It wasn't a very good day for either of us, was it?
Today? Oh, it's too far away. Let's not think about it. I'm just enjoying being with you. Two coffees, please. Have you, heard anything about the Barnhurst position?
Nothing definite yet, but it looks good.
Oh, don't worry, you'll get it. Well, you've got the qualifications. I'd give you the job.
It's what I've always wanted.
What about husband, family?
Every woman would like that, I think. But a good relationship isn't easy to come by. Being governor, well, at least I know I can handle that.
I think you could handle anything you put your mind to. Vera, I know things have been going a bit haywire for us lately, but I'd like you to think about it. Will you do that? Will you think about us?
All right.
Hey, let's drink to the future.
The future.
What I said before, you're not completely against the idea, are you?
No. A short time ago, I was planning on marrying you. My feelings don't change.